Okay, so we can start. This evening we have as a guest speaker Dr. Engineer Lorenzo Pini, who is one of the one of the designers and the research center of the BTC Nolle Grand company, which is one of the main manufacturers here in Italy and France for smart home devices, and especially for the My Home system, which is one of their offer in the smart building market. He's here to tell us about their My Home system, their applications, and say to open to your curiosity and questions. So I won't steal any more time from Lorenzo, and I give him the floor.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you. Just to tell you who am I. I work in BTC. I started working in BTC in 2003. Since the beginning, I was in charge to work in the home automation part of the offer of BTC. At the beginning, I was a software tester and a web developer. Then, by the time I changed my occupation and right now I'm in charge to develop integration among BTC systems and several other third party, as could be Klima from Daikin, Klima from Mitsubishi, or management of intelligent light as a U or DMX protocol for RGB and so on. I have also often the opportunity to speak about home automation, not only in university, but also in front of electrical installer and so on. And that's why I decided to divide in two, three steps this presentation. In the first one, I will speak a little bit about what, in my opinion, is home automation, how is the market in Italy, because here we are in Italy, and then I will present you how my home works. Here I have a little system, so at the end, who is interested could ask me. And then at the end, I will show you the language Open WebNet, that is the public language that BTC has to control the my home system. Normally when I speak about home automation, I got this kind of question. It's true that home automation increases comfort. Obviously, from my point of view, the answer is yes. It's also true that home automation improves life quality. Yes, consider this. I go out, my wife starts to ask me, did we close the gas? Did we close the water? The answer normally is no, I cannot. Instead, with home automation, I can. If I program in the right way my system, if I use the right device, when I design at the beginning the house, it's easy to be used. Yes, consider that my daughter, 4 years old, she's confident with the new technology, and she's usual to say, switch off or switch on light spot kitchen using my smartphone. This means that home automation is not so complicated. That, for sure, my father or my mother has some problem, but they have problem with a mobile phone too. It's really reliable. I would say yes. Consider that this system, my home, but also KNX system, other system, are not systems that are on the market since 2 years, 3 years, but are technology developed in the last 20 years. My house is a lab test because we test device before to go on the market, and I often test new device. All the devices in my house are prototype. I touch myself. I never had fault. So what is in my house is there since when I install it. Can I find an electrical installer able to install home automation? This is a difficult question. Yes, but we will see later that it's not so easy to find people able to manage this kind of technology. Can I save money? Yes, I can. I will show you a page in which I show you the electrical consumption in my house, and I will show you how I was able to reduce the consumption of the bill, the money by the bill in my house. And how much does it cost? This is the main question that I got when I speak about home automation. The answer is not so easy, because we have to consider many things. Normally, an home automation system costs a little bit more or a lot more. It depends on what you want to install in your house, and it depends who is going to install home automation in your house. I will go fast to this part, but what is home automation? From my point of view, we can speak about home automation when we speak about all the technology that could be installed in your house as automation for light, for shutter, for curtain, or the alarm, the appliance control, your washing machine, for example, audio and video for sound or for CCTV. But also, we have to consider the management of the information. So I'm in the house, I'm not in the house. There is someone in the kitchen or is not in the kitchen. And the possibility to manage this information when I'm in the house or when I'm out of the house. Consider this. We are used, every one of us, to use piece of home automation. The alarm system, at the end, is home automation. The shutter motorized are a piece of the home automation. Your automatic gate when you come back home is a piece of home automation, and so on. When we move from this piece to a full home automation system, when all this piece of technology are able to speak each other, and they are able to cooperate to make integrated action. So I go out, I pass the badge in front of the alarm detector, and I switch off at the same time the lights, I close the shutter, I close the valve of the gas and the water, I switch off the sound if I have sound in my house, and so on. I can change the program of my fridge to Echo. That's become home automation. If you consider just one function, alarm, this is not home automation. It's a piece of something that could become home automation if all the systems in the house are able to speak each other. We are in Torino, so show you a 500L is a must. Consider this. I was speaking before with Fulvio, and I told him that we are so used to have option, or better, we consider before option in our car something that now is not anymore an option. This is the key of my car. You can see that I don't have to put it to switch on the car. It's enough that I have this in the car to switch on the car. Or I can close and open via radio command. But also, if you consider cristalli elettrici in Italian. Si taglia un po', fa niente. If I consider the windows, who would buy now house a car that now that you have to use the thing so to open or close the windows? No one we are used to have this kind of facility in a car. For a car, I mean, what before was considered luxury now is essential, is something that you want in your car. I would say that this is because we change our needs and we consider comfort something that now is in the standard equipment of our auto. Is it the same for home automation for your house? I would say no, it's not so. It's a little bit different when we consider our car that has 10 years of life, if we are lucky. And we compare with our house that normally has to be alive for 20, 30 years. So speaking about the market of home automation, what is blocking now the market? Not so much people know home automation and the feature and the benefit of home automation. What I always say is that home automation is something that is invisible in your house. I explained before to Fulvio that if you come in my house, you would not understand that there is home automation because you have the normal switches. The only difference that you can see is that I have a LED per each switch. So how I can understand the benefit? Just living in my house and appreciating the function of that home automation and the capacity to all that all the little piece of automation in the house are able to speak together. So this give me a benefit. Then another point, if you hear on TV, on a magazine about home automation, they speak about the house of the future. So you are not happy to see, to know that something that an installer wants to install in your house is, it would be something of the future. Because you think that this would not work. Is it reliable? Yes or no? So we have to speak about something that exists now. As I told you, electrical installer, architect, designer, right now has not a good knowledge about the function of the home automation and about the benefit that they can give to the customer, so to the person who lives in a house. It's open FN, I've seen this on the market, that a builder proposes you an home automation house, and then you come in the house and you say, which is the difference? No one, because they replace the normal switches to switch on a light with intelligent one, like this, without giving you the possibility to use all the benefit that an home automation system can give to who leaves the house. Then there are some other aspects, like the fact that you can upgrade your automation system by the time. You don't have to install all at the beginning. You can wire the cable and then add new function 1 year later, 2 years later. It's difficult to ask to an installer to come back in a house and change a configuration or to add something more. Normally, this is in Italy, but not only in Italy, the installer close the installation, say bye-bye to the customer. Another point is the cost. I would not stay to speak along about the cost because we can speak for 1 hour. It's true that an home automation system costs more, but it's also true that normally we compare the electrical system, so light on off the normal traditional one, with a full home automation system. Instead, if you start to consider that in your house you have alarm, motor for shutter, lights, sound, and you want these for your automation. And then you have to pay for different system. The sum of these two potential offers normally are not so different. Could be maximum 30% more, but not often. Normally we have seen that the cost of a home automation system integrated with the same technology and different pieces of automation, as I told you, shutter, light, and so on, cost more or less the same. These are the consumption in my house. I want to show this because, as you can see here, in September 2012, I installed in my house a new device that we launched on the market that allows you to see your consumption. So I was able to see my consumption. And I discovered a lot of things. For example, that the standby of my washing machine is 5 watts. The standby of my Sony television is 11 watts, and so on. So I start to program some scenarios in my house using the technology that my home offered me to switch off all the standby. during the night, it's not useful to have the modem if you are not downloading films on, or the Sky decoder because you're sleeping. So the Sky decoder consumes 25 watts also when it's off. So programming, right, programming scenarios that close a contact on an actuator, I was able to switch off, the decoder, the modern router, and so on. And so I was able to save a lot of money on my bill. You can see that the medium, here we don't have the money, but we can see that the monthly average in 2010 was 250 kilowatts per month. Now we are 116, so an half. This to say that just knowing about the consumption and optimizing the function that I have in my house, programming scenarios, I was able to save money. It's more or less 20 euros per month. Okay, speaking about the Italian market, we can see that from 2000 till 2007, 2008, there was the market was increasing a lot. Then the crisis started and the market is going down. This is related to the fact that we don't build any more new house. The market now moves to the rebuilding, so we rebuild the house that already exists. This comes from ANCE, that is the Italian consortium of the builder. What we can see is that from 2008 till 2013, new houses are less 40%, real estate market is less 30%. But we can see that right now the 33% of the houses in Italy, so considering also the old one, have one or more automation system, let me say the alarm, the motorized, the shutter. If we consider the new house, the 59% in Trentino are 73% as automation, not home automation as I explained to you, but automation in the house. And the 16% of new house as have inside the home automation system. If we want to see how is divided the market and who are the players on the market, this pyramid explains you what. That on the top of the pyramid, we have so luxury installation, big villa, more or less big villa. The player could be company normally from US, like Vantage, EMX. The system that manages here the room is an EMX system, or Creston. If we consider the basic installation, for basic I mean not an house that has a home automation, so means the 16% of the market that I told you before, not the 100%. The player on the market in Italy are these. We have Bticino that has the 65% of the market share. Then we have Vimar or Gevis that are the two biggest players behind the Bticino. Then we have system based on the KNX bus solution as could be ABB, Siemens and so on. In the middle, we have other kind of company as Control4, Savant, RTI, that are able, as Vantage, EMX, Crestron, to integrate all this kind of brand because they have a centralized technology with a sort of PC able to speak, thanks to a gateway, with this system and providing graphical interface easily not, but fully customizable in the way that from a touch panel, from an application, I can go to control several different systems in the same installation. If you have any question, stop me, please. Okay, who are the players of the home automation market? We have electrical installer, system integrator, so people able to manage different systems in the same installation, the architect and the designer, not the interior designer, the designer of the house, and for sure the final user. Why? Because in the 60% of the situation is the final user that asks for home automation, is not the builder or the electrical store that proposed it. And where I can see a home automation system, in a villa, a flat, a luxury solution like a yacht or a hotel for new house or a building. Speaking about the Italian market, the player in the market are Bitticino, Vimar, Gevis, and then you would find a lot of company that propose you home automation, as DoMG, EasyDom, HomePLC, now also company that maybe you know because Comalit is from Torino, produce video door entry system, il citofono per capirci, are starting now to sell on the market something that they call domotica. So you will find a lot of company that propose home automation on the market, but you have to understand what they propose you. Is just the control of the light and the shutter, or is a full integrated system that allows you to manage different family of automation? I work in Bitticino, so I have to speak to you about Bitticino C solution. The brand name of the home automation provided by Bitticino is called My Home. We are on the market since 98. But the first installation were done in 93-94. We have a large family of product and function that we can manage at the same time with the same technology. Light, automation, for automation I mean the gate or the shutter and so on. Sheen, it means the possibility to coordinate action, I mean I go out, as I told you before, I make a different action in the house at the same time. Sound diffusion, bar grill alarm, temperature control, energy management, video door entry system, and remote access. All these technology are based on the same technology. Here I have a very basilar system. This white and blue is our bus, called SCS bus. All the family of automation that I previously explained to you use this bus to communicate each other. Is in the next step. So, what is important is that, as I told you before, you can plan to install a part of the system and then you can extend the installation, adding, for example, the management of the energy, as I've done in my house, or the control of the temperature. Speaking about the SCS, this is not a centralized system. So all the device that you can see here has a sort of brain. So they have the intelligence to understand what he has to do and what is they have to communicate to the other device on the system, speaking on the bus. If this command has a fault, the system continues to work. If we consider the Crestron Vantage, so the American system, normally they are based on a centralized intelligence. So there is a master controller who receives signal from the field, from the house, and decide what to do. So if I have a fault in the master control, nothing works. Speaking about my home, I'm proud to say that it's an open system. Why? Because it's true that the bus has a private language, but we provide on IP, thanks to a gateway, a public protocol. The protocol name is Open WebNet. We will speak later. Thanks to this public protocol, you are able to develop your app. If you are skilled in iOS developing, you are able to develop an application for iPhone and you can sell it on the market. If you go on Google Play or iTunes and you look for My Home Bitticino, you will find applications that were developed not by Bitticino, but by other company that they make money selling application to control My Home. What does it mean, SES? SES is the name of the Bitticino bus. It means simplified cabling system. It was in Italian, the name, but then we were lucky because it fit also in English. We were lucky because we thought the system in the 90 years, so when you are born, more or less. And we didn't thought to sell this system all over the world, but we thought to the Italian market. Then we understood that we were able, we are right now able to sell this system all over the world. I forgot to tell you something. Bitticino is part of an international group, the Group Le Grand is French, and we are able to cover more or less all the country in the world. There are some markets in which we are very strong, like be Mexico or Latin America. If you go there, you will see, you will find shops that sell Bitticino products. Some other country, we are well known with the brand Le Grand. Some feature about our bus. It's a twisted pair. It means that it's like the telephone cable, okay? So you can you don't need a specific wire to cable our system. As I told you, we provide a protocol. We use a private protocol with an hexadecimal syntax. The syntax, so the language on the bus, is the same for all the family of product on the catalog. Every device is certified by us. And if something doesn't work, is the Group Le Grand in Bitticino in Italy that has to assist you. On the SES bus, we use the SES bus for different things. On the same bus, so on the same, we are able to try to manage four kind of signal: power to supply all the device connected to the bus. We exchange data, so if I press here, the information come on the bus, and there is there will be another device able to understand it and react. We are also able to manage video and audio in banda base. Then some feature, we use CSMACA for the transmission, is 9600 Hz. Is not polarized, so you can connect in a way or in the other without any problem, and it's 27 volt DC. All the device connected to the bus has inside a PIC, so a microprocessor. This processor normally is programmed in assembler or in C. It depends from the cost of the device and from the function that he has to do. You can configure this device, and then we will see how, and the configuration that I give to this device assign an address and the logical weight that the modality that he has to use to work on the bus. Just to see something about how we cable the system. Speaking about just light and shutter, this is a picture that shows you how a home automation system works. It's based on My Home, but more or less all the home automation system works in this way. So if you will see a KNX system or another technology, the cabling is this. You have commands, control, that could be a command, a switches, push button, with push button, could be a touch screen, could be, this is a glass, capacitive glass, with six LEDs. Each LED, when it's pressed, makes something. On the same bus, I have connected what we call actuator. So this kind of device. Inside there is a relay that open and close a contact and allows you to provide energy to loads that could be lights, different kind of lights. What is interesting is this, is the same picture before. That is not important that the first one, where is connected the first one, because the first push button can go to control this actuator, but if I change the configuration in 2 minutes, I'm able to control this or that or the other one. If you consider a traditional system, when you wire your system and you understand that this push button is not go to control this light, but you never use this and you prefer to control the lights there, you have to rewire all, to take out from the wall the wire. With the normal automation system, this activity is pretty easy, just changing the configuration of this device. Then, some system are easy to in some system is easy to change the configuration, in some other no, but what makes the difference is the fact that this device has an intelligence that allows you to make one function as which on this light, or a group of functions as which shone all the light here in this room, or if I understand that the configuration that I have done is not useful, I can change the configuration and go to control the light of the garden. Speaking about the temperature control system, it's more or less the same. We have a central unit, because normally you are used to have the chronothermostat in your house with the profile of temperature that you want hour per hour. So that is the logic, obviously. If this device go down, the system stop to work, or in part stop to work. Then we have probes that you can install in all your room that measure temperature and have inside the logic to go to control the actuator. So I can open or close the valves or the pump to heat or cool your room. Probe, actuators, and so on. If you consider, it seems complex or confusing, these slides, but it's just to tell you that we can cover also energy management features, functions. Using a particular device, we are able to read the consumption of the different line that you have in your house, and you can provide this information on touchscreen, application, and so on. Or, for example, here in Italy, you know we have a limit of consumption, 3 kilowatts normally. When you go over 3 kilowatts, our friendly Enel cut the line and we are without energy in the house. With such kind of system, there is a device, in this case is this one, able to understand which are our consumption, and if the consumption go over 3 kilowatts, it starts to close contact. It could switch off your washing machine or the oven or lights or the clima in the way that we go under 3 kilowatts and we don't pay more money, because when we go over 3 kilowatts and it'll ask you 55% more in the bill and we to stay without light. Okay, speaking about the configuration, the difference that we have from the competitor is how it's easy to configure a device. This is a push button. I have two ways to configure this. The first one is using a physical configurator. So we have a sort of brick that we can put behind the device. This brick has a meaning, 1, 2, 3, so it's a number that gives the address to this device. Then we can do the same using a software, but most of the installer prefer the basic configuration. Here we have a limited number of brick that we can insert. So with the virtual configuration, so I mean the configuration via software, we can also configure in with advanced functions the device. If we consider other systems like the KNX system, you need a software to configure all the device, and it's pretty complex to become skilled in the configuration of this kind of system. Instead, this kind of configuration with the physical bricks is easy to be understood also from our electrical installer. Just an example. If I want to configure an actuator, I have four bricks. E means area, light point, group, and modality. So if I put here area number one and light point number two, it means that this device goes to control the light that is the second light in the area number one, maybe the kitchen. How do I have to configure a push button to control the actuator? Just replacing one here and two here. So in 30 seconds, I'm able to connect these two devices, the push button and the relay, that then is connected to my lamp. This kind of configuration, I repeat, it's really easy. You have in the laboratory some piece of this, and probably you will have the opportunity to play with that and find alone how it's easy to configure this device. This is what you are used to do in your house. Configuration, first push button 1-1 and actuator 1-1. It means that the first push button controls the first light. The second one, 1-2, 1-2 means second push button, second light. This is what I call a traditional system. In a home automation system, you can start to do different kind of action from the same push button. What I mean? I mean that if I change the configuration of my push button and I say that I want to control all the light in the area number one, I'm able with one push button to control three lights. So in, I can create a scenario that switch on all the light of my kitchen, of my living room, or of the area in which we sleep. Or I can switch on all the light of the first floor with one push button, without to go in all the room, switching off all the light. In our system, there is another concept that is the group control. So if I want to switch on two lights that are in two different areas, it's just a configuration of this device, and pressing the push button, I can control one light here and the other light in the other room. But they are in two different areas. And to close this part, with one push button, if I want to control all the light in the system, it's just the configuration of this. I don't have to go to the, I don't know, it's in English, to cut all the light in my house. It's enough to press this push button. This could be an example of configuration in which we have several commands and a lot of actuators. What is important is that I can configure more push buttons with the same address, so I can switch on this light from a different point, as you're used to do in your house. But then you have to wire in a particular way all the installation with the deviata invertita, I don't know, it's in English, that is pretty complex to be wired. Okay. I had a piece. So we spoke right now about the physical system. I had something that is not anymore private, because what is on this bus is private. As I told you before, we have a public language called the Open WebNet. You can download all the documents from my website, myopen-legrandgroup.com. It's a web community that can that born to support who want to use this protocol, this language. This language can be used via TCP IP thanks to a gateway that is connected to the bus. So using the Open WebNet, you are able to switch on a light or to know the status of the light in your room, to know if there is an alarm in your house or not, to read the temperature outside or in all the room, and so on, to increase the volume or decrease the volume if you switch on your radio. This protocol was born in 2000, so we use it since a lot of time. It's public. And what is interesting from my point of view is that there is an Italian consortium called DomLab. We had we opened a showroom in Milano in January. In the consortium there is Bitticino, Ariston Thermo Group for the boiler, Indesit for the appliance, so washing machine, dishing machine, fridge, and so on, Teuco that make pool or sauna. And all these companies choose OpenWebNet as language to make integration among this different system. If you want to get some information about OpenWebNet, this is the website. Normally in the forum, who answers is me, my colleague Giulia, and some other colleague. I know that you have to develop a project to pass the exam. Else. So probably some of you choose to work with OpenWebNet and with the MyOM technology. So I will show you how is the language OpenWebNet. I have not so much time, so I have to run. Sorry. I complex all in a few minutes. The language was born in 2000. This means that we started to thought about the language before. If you consider this in 2000, there was internet as we have now. There wasn't the smartphone, but we have just we have the cordless. But normally, what we had were the Nokia, like my Nokia. Our mobile phone were not with the display, with the keypad, and which kind of control we have on the keypad? We have a number, star and dash. So we had to adapt our language to the technology that we had in 2000. So we thought a syntax pretty easy, done with star, hash, and number. And we divide the sentence in this way. The star is the beginning of the communication of the sentence. The double hash close the sentence. The star in the middle are used to divide the field. And then we will understand what is a field. In the field, I can find number or the hash. For example, if I want to make an action on light, I start my sentence in this way. Normally, a sentence is done with a field that we could call who, so the family of the object that I want to control. For example, the who number one is for the light. What is the action that I want to do? I want to switch off, so if I check on the table, I will see that the field what off is zero. And then I have the address of the device that I want to control. I want to control a group of light. The syntax is hash one. So writing this kind of message on TCP IP connected to this gateway, I'm able to go to control a light. This was able, we were able using an SMS in 2000 to switch on your light in your house thanks to the keyboard of your phone. Now, for sure, we can use different technology, but you have to consider that to sell device on the market, you have also to reduce the cost to produce these, because you have to sell to the low price that you can to get the market share. So it happens that also, for example, Elica that makes cappe, I don't know English, has a very low-cost hardware, and using REST call JavaScript or a JSON communication, it costs too much. So this language is really easy to be used. Just an example, if you open a telnet to this device, you can digit this sentence and you can switch on the light. So telnet, it's a socket. We are not speaking about to manage the parsing of an XML and so on. Just open a socket, write this sentence, and you switch on a light. Maybe, no, I cannot. But we can during the break, I can show you. Okay, we have five kind of field. The who, that explains you who is the family of the device that we want to control. Where is the address of the device? What is an action? For dimension, we mean, for example, a temperature is not an action. If I want to read the value of temperature in this room, I have to use a field that we call dimension and read the value in the field value. Just some example. I want to switch on off a light, the light number one in the area three. That's the syntax. Who, zero. Who, one means light. What, zero means off. 31 is the address of the light. I want to read the volume of the amplifier. I check on the table, I discover that this is the sentence that I have to understand, and it's pretty easy. I want to request the status of an alarm, that's the sentence. It's a sort of API, of primitive API, okay? On the My Open Community, you will find a lot of PDF that describe you family per family, the language. So you will find, for example, a table like this in which you can find per each family of function the corresponding value. Speaking about Open Web, then we have to consider four kinds of messages. One, to command or read the status of a device, to switch on or off, or to know the status of this device. One, to request the status of the device. Then we have a family of message to request to read the value or to write a value of a dimension, like the temperature, like the volume, like the frequency of your radio, and so on. And then acknowledgement and not acknowledgement. Okay. Consider our gateway. Our gateway is connected to the bus from one side and to the IP to the other side. This is what we have done to develop our gateway. We have the home automation system with the bus protocol. Then we have to be able to translate the information from the bus to the IP. So inside this device, there is a sort of software layer divided in different layer in which we have to manage the bus protocol. We have a middle layer that translates information from SES to another one, to another language that is the Open WebNet. This layer take care of the bus. This layer take care of the translation from SES to Open WebNet and vice versa. This layer takes care of the communication on IP. So if you will develop an application or something, you will connect your gateway, the gateway, using TCP/IP. So there is a part that we call Open WebNet Server of the gateway layer that is able to accept a communication on a specific port and allows you to share information using the language Open WebNet. If you want to develop an application, for sure you will develop an user interface. Then there will be a layer that you can develop as you want, because a push button on a graphical interface can call a REST, can use JSON, can use whatever you want. And then you will have a client able to speak with Open Server, following some rules that I will show. If we want to see in the deep how works our translation layer, we have many pieces of dictionary. Each all these different. So let me say we have one dictionary per each kind of family, per each family of a device. So we have a dictionary for light, we have a dictionary for temperature control, and so on. This is useful. Why? Because if I modify or I add a new sentence in OpenWebNet, I don't have to modify all the layer, but just the dictionary that I use for light or for something else. Okay. How works the communication with the gateway? As I told you, it's enough a telnet, so open a socket to a specific port to control, to send or exchange open webnet message. We have implemented two different kinds of socket. One to command the system, to control, to go to control the system. I want to switch on a light, so I have to open a socket and write this information. This kind of socket we call command connection can be opened and closed all the time that you want. But if your software wants to be synchronized with the status of the house, of the system, you need a permanent connection that we call a monitor connection. So this communication is open from the client, and all that happens on the system is forwarded to the client. So if I switch on one light on this socket, I will read this information. If the temperature changes in the room, the information is written in the bus. The gateway translates this information and provides this information to the software that you are developed using the monitor connection. Here I have too many things. Okay, I jump something. We use the port 20,000 for the communication, so you can digit telnet IP of the gateway space 20,000 to open the communication. We register on IANA, we have an official port for OpenWebNet that is the 20005, but we still continue to use the other one. Just to see how works the communication. Here I have my client, so my software, and to the other side I have the gateway. Normally the flow is, I open a connection, I choose which kind of communication I want, to command the system or to monitor the system, and then the communication starts. Just an example. I open my socket, I choose using a message open webnet that I want to open a command socket. I receive an acknowledgement from my gateway, and then I can start to communicate with the gateway, for example, switching on the light number 77 or requesting the set point that I want in the room 21. And I get as feedback the temperature in the room, that is 21.5 degrees, the temperature, the set point. Just an example, if a software request want to switch on a light, has to send this sentence 1.1.11 to the gateway. The gateway translates the information and switch on the light on the system and gives feedback an acknowledgement to the gateway, just to say that the operation was done. I can also request information of how is the status of the light 23. As feedback, I have the status of the light. Instead, when I want to monitor the system, I open the connection. I choose disappear. I choose the monitor socket, and then I receive from the gateway information coming from the system. As you can see here, you don't write; you just read what's happened. So if I switch on a light without to ask to the gateway will forward me the information that the light is on. and many other kind of messages. Okay. I would like to show you something because this is really technical. This is a client that we develop to monitor what's happened on the bus. For example, if I press the push button on this actuator, what you can see is that I have a communication that is asynchronous without that I ask to the system what's happened. Here you can read the sentence that means that the actuator, the address of the actuator is #1, was on. Or if I consider the probe of temperature, if I press a special push button, you can see here messages. These messages notify you that I'm changing the fan speed of a fan coil, for example, or of your Daikin air condition. If I connect this push button, now is available. When I press the push button, don't consider the 13. When I press the push button, I read that something was done on the system. It means that I just pressed this push button. If I keep holding the push button, here you will have another sentence that tells you that someone is hanging the push button. This is useful because you can use this kind of configuration not to pilot point-to-point light, but to go to control a third-party system. When I press here, a third-party system know that you are pressing this push button. So there could be software, something else, that use this information to go to control, for example, in on or off your air condition or a third-party system of audio or video. I can do the same, I delete here. I can, for example, switch on the actuator here. This sentence allow me to switch on this actuator. If I press here, the LED change in on, I get an ACK from the gateway and read the new status of the device on my software. Here, without that I ask you, that I ask to the system, I can read the temperature in the room, I mean here, 24.1 degree. So the device are able to write on the bus and provide feedback so that you can use this feedback to synchronize a graphical interface or to read the temperature when you are outside or inside your house. I was very fast, I know, maybe too much, but I have 1 hour. If you have any question related to my home, or related to the home automation market, or something that interests you for the project, I'm here.
Which are the main trends now in the field you research on?
Sorry, which is the?
The main trends. Like
the trends? Look, as I showed you at the beginning, the market now is going. Which is the main trends on the market. So, as I showed you at the beginning, the market is, especially in Italy, but also in general in Europe, you know, the crisis doesn't help. But we can see that new house, we are increasing the market share of home automation. In percentage, there are less home automation houses in comparison to 2008. But if you consider the new house on the market built now, the number of new houses with home automation are increasing. We have to consider also the trend of the technology. To install a home automation system, normally you have to wire a house because a wired system is more robust than a wireless system. For example, we have a company in the Group Legrand called Nuvo that makes some system as Sonos. Maybe someone of you heard about Sonos. If you go on MediaWorld, it's possible that you find a Wi-Fi offered for some system called the Sonos. This technology is based on Wi-Fi, so you have streaming of audio with the good quality in your house. You can have an amplifier, Wi-Fi, so you can put this wherever you want. You just need to provide the power supply. Then there is a Wi-Fi streaming, and you connect your loudspeaker to the amplifier wherever you want, which is the biggest problem of this kind of solution. Not the cost, not the quality of the audio, but the Wi-Fi pollution that you have in your house. Because if it's a villa, probably you do not have any kind of pollution around you. But if I consider where I live in Milan, I can see 20 or more Wi-Fi network. So which is the trend? Also speaking about technology. The wired system, from my point of view, are more robust and will continue to be installed. But are coming on the market new offers like the Philips Hue for light, for RGB light, and many other kind of devices. So probably we will see in the next 5-10 years a merge of this technology. We will see on the market push button like this, but probably with Wi-Fi inside, or in part wired to manage a wired device, and in part able to go to control Wi-Fi or Zigbee or Z-Wave devices. That's, in my opinion, how the market is moving. Not only my opinion, also because I'm in the market and we have to study the trend to be ready to follow the market. So I can tell you that we are trying to understand how to make this device more and more smart. Yeah. Okay. The question is, do we never thought to use the wired network to control the system? Yes. At the first home automation system, we're based on the on this kind of technology, but everyone decided to don't use anymore this kind of technology because of the noise. And because of some limits regarding the transmission data, and more or less that's the reason.
Many years ago, I see a presentation from Manuel that showed at the time was there was this idea to stream internet through the NL.
Yeah.
That idea was I don't know where.
It's because of the noise. More or less, it's because of the noise of this kind of technology.
Mm-hmm. So a top, and every single twisted pair is a bus for communicating to the other devices or to the other.
So you haven't considered of using more sophisticated technology or...
I resume the question. Do we ever consider to use more sophisticated technology instead of a bus solution? Yes, there is a key point. How much is easy to configure a system, and how much does it cost a device? You can sell a device if the cost is not too much. So probably to use more sophisticated technology costs too much. Just to tell you something, normally our product marketing asks every year to reduce the cost of this device. If we want to reduce the cost of this device because we have to increase the margin because maybe this costs 100 and the next year has to cost 105, or because of the crisis, has to cost 90. But we have to maintain the margin because the investor wants money, to keeping money from our system. So we have also to reduce the cost of this device, and we have to choose technology that really cost not so much and are easy to be upgraded by the time. Consider that the obsolescence of the component is 6 months, 1 year, not more. So it means that every year you have to redesign the board, more or less. You can see this with your mobile phone. Every year you have a new mobile phone with new function, with new hardware. Always smallest, but the same price. So, okay, that technology are becoming smaller and smaller, but so power means also cost. No. We use a socket with a string. Not XML.
No, I was speaking SMS.
Sorry. If you have a device that is able to receive an SMS and write in IP versus our gateway, yes. For example, our alarm Bargral alarm central unit is able to receive SMS and make action on the system. Yes. So, for example, in 2000 was easy because we had this kind of mobile phone. In 2014, we have a smartphone, so it's easier to have an app. With your app, you can do whatever you want in the house, obviously if you have the device, and the device support this kind of language.
I would maybe add the question about
I would jump on this question about the innovation. You said one of the reasons is cost. What is the weight of compatibility in the choosing to change the technology? The compatibility with the
previous one.
Yes.
Okay. You mean about regarding our system?
Yes.
Right now, our policy is that all the device, new device, except if you add a new function, so there is no retrocompatibility, but also in the SES bus and also in the Open WebNet, switch on one light is the same sentence. So if a new switch is a new patch button, okay, you have an installation done in 2000, and for some reason there is a fault on your push button, you can go on the wholesaler, grossista, and buy a new device that probably for the push button is still the same code. So you have new board, new technology, completely different from the previous one, and it still works. The same for the actuator, for the probe of temperature system. This is really a problem when you have to develop a system and maintain the system in the market for many years, because all the limits that you didn't consider at the beginning, you still have now. So you have to slalom, you have to have a slalom in this thing. Considering the switches, yes, you can. If you go, if you find the catalog of Mayom in year 2000, the same, we still have the same code. For example, for the probe change, now we have a new probe with a display that show you the temperature and also the set point that you want in the room. But you can go in a system already installed, as I have done at home. Remove the old one without display and put the new one that has a new code, new technology, because there is a display, and nothing changed. Because the bus language remains the same, and at the same time, the Open WebNet language is the same. We developed also some years ago a device, a gateway, that was, you was used Open WebNet to control a different kind of bus, the QNX bus. So the idea of our language, Open WebNet, is to abstract the field, so the bus language. In fact, as I told you before, OMLAB, that is this Italian consortium of research, used Open WebNet to control different family of system, to switch on the light inside the fridge, the frame, the message is the same, to switch on the light here, nothing changed.
We are more or less over with the time, so I would like to thank Lorenzo for his speech, and I'm sure that in the break that we will have, he will be able to answer also some questions that maybe you don't want to ask in public, or to see the gadget and touch them. Just be careful.
No. There is low voltage, so there is no problem.
Okay, let's do a 10 minutes break. Thank you, Lorenzo.
Grazie.